Hairline advancement, do I need it? Cost, do you think I need it? I can't wear my hair pulled back in a ponytail. I always have to part it in the front. My head still looks disproportionately large. What can I do?
Thank you for your question. You're asking about advancement of the hairline and do you need it? Well, that is of course a subjective question, but I would say that you should first have an understanding of the pattern of your hair in relationship to your family history. So if you come from a family where people tend to have very high foreheads, then naturally that's probably fine and that's your family's unique characteristic. But if you feel that your hairline is receding, now that's a whole other different story. What I would advise is to look into your personal habits, of course. Very commonly with women, we find a lot of women have something called traction alopecia. Now, traction alopecia is based on a lot of women who wear their ponytails or their hair is pulled back very tightly. And some people have even come to us who said that they actually pull their hair back tightly to literally lift their brows. And they did that for many years, but eventually the hair, because of the traction and the pulling, the hairs became nonviable. And then their hairline, of course, receded. So if you feel that your hairline is receding, you need to investigate why. Is it because of traction? Is it from female pattern hair loss or male pattern hair loss? Because even women can have a pattern of hair loss by like temporal recession of the peaks and receding hairline like a male in terms of male pattern, but not and still have that look of receding hairline. So even though it's not, you're not a man, you could still have, quote, male pattern hair loss. So to understand then what to do, women have fewer options if they are truly receding and if all hormonal causes have been eliminated. Typically, when a patient comes to our practice, we always ask about hormone levels, medications, other factors that could be associated with a more metabolic basis for hair loss before we make the diagnosis of a pattern of hair loss. Now, once you've established that, then a certain percentage of our patients will even do biopsies to determine if there is any other inflammation or scarring. Assuming all of that is fine and you're still receding, well, I'm going to introduce you to a concept called hair regeneration. And in my practice, I'm a multi-specialty cosmetic surgeon, and I've been a hair restoration surgeon for over 10 years. In the past 3 years, I have been very focused on a new technology of hair regeneration. A material called extracellular matrix, which was originally designed for wound healing, I've been able to successfully apply in combination with a byproduct of your own blood, or I should say a fraction of your own blood called platelet-rich plasma, to literally reverse the thinning of hair and restoring volume and thickness to hair that's thinning. You see, it seems that this wound healing mechanism helps to reactivate stem cells and specifically cells known as progenitor cells, which are responsible for the material that the hair is made of and the activation of a part of the hair called the dermal papilla. And so a lot of our patients who come to us who consider transplanting, hairline advancement, forehead reduction, we often choose to do a non-surgical procedure. And by doing this injection treatment, we have helped a lot of our patients avoid a surgical procedure. You see, unfortunately, a surgical procedure in hair transplantation, such as hair transplantation, it's almost like taking a slice of time where you can look good for a certain amount of time, but if you end up continuously having thinning hair, it's like you're on a treadmill and you're just moving, but you're going nowhere. So what we want to do is stop the process and then reverse it so that even if you chose to do a transplant, the transplant would be done with the anticipation that the hair thinning process won't continue, at least to the amount of time that our data currently supports, which is so far a minimum of 3 years. We have not had to re-inject people. And what the future is depends a lot on the clinical observations we make over time. Again, this is very leading edge material. So if you feel, again, to summarize, if you feel like you're receding, and your hair is thinning, if you were to come to our office, I'd actually use a microscope, look at your scalp, and try to evaluate the proportion of normal hairs or terminal hairs compared to the hairs that are thinning, and then make a recommendation about what to do. If we see a lot of thinning hairs, then the injection is actually a wonderful option to help restore and literally reverse the hair thinning process. So learn more about your process, your situation, and you know, think about more about your progression rather than going for a surgical solution at this time. Once you've learned all your options, I'm sure you'll be able to make a more informed decision. So I hope that was helpful. Thank you for your question.